Thank you, Lori, Kevin, and the LJYO musicians for that wonderful opening piece, Carillon, from the Arlesian Suite No. 1 by Bizet. For your interest, a carillon is a huge keyboard used to ring bells in towers, such as our Parliament Building in Ottawa and old churches. The continuous bell tones that you just heard in our performance were played by Lorne Horwood and Jeff Mitchell, so thank you both. Bizet wrote many famous works. Perhaps most famous was his opera Carmen, which gained most of its fame after his death from poor health at the age of 38. You may be interested to know that Carillon was written to accompany a play, and the bell tones in Carillon were used in a scene in which a young girl was meeting a young man with wedding bells on her mind. Now for our land acknowledgement. As an act of respect and reconciliation, we acknowledge that this church and the surrounding geography is on the traditional lands of the Mississauga and Anishinaabeg peoples. This land has been the site of human activity for thousands of years. We come together mindful of the history and the legacy of the residential school system, the 60s scoop, and the continued separation of families. These lands are still the home of many Indigenous people, and we are neighbors. And we are also mindful of broken covenants and the need to make right in all our relations. Today we're celebrating the accomplishments of our orchestra and put the spotlight on 8 of our members who successfully auditioned to perform as soloists. In the spotlight has become a tradition for LJYO, and each year it is exciting to see what our students select to perform and who steps forward for this wonderful yet daunting opportunity. You will hear a wide variety, so a big learning curve for our young orchestra, but also a lot of fun. Our preparation period was affected dramatically by the pandemic. We had to have Zoom rehearsals almost all of January. Our soloists have enthusiastically stepped up and spent countless hours working on their solos. The orchestra itself works particularly hard to help our soloists shine, and their unwavering support of our soloists is admirable. We hope you enjoy the fruits of the soloists' and orchestra's labors. Our first soloist this afternoon is Ara Gajevi. Ara is playing the violin concerto in G major by Haydn. Haydn lived to the age of 77 and in his full life wrote more than 100 symphonies, 68 string quartets, more than 20 concertos, as well as operas and masses. The concerto that Ara will perform was written around 1769 at a time when Haydn was established as a composer and wrote music to entertain royalty. He played in beautiful castles such as Esterhazy Castle in Austria. Ara has been taking violin lessons with Lori Mitchell for 7 years. She has been with this orchestra for 4 years. Playing music with others brings Ara great joy. She feels that LJYO pushes her to constantly improve her playing and helps her immensely with reading music. Ara chose this piece because of its variety of melodies, from fast and frantic to sweet and slow. Thank you, Ira, for your beautiful solo. Your hard work and commitment has paid off. Also, thank you to our orchestra for helping Ira to shine this afternoon. Our musicians rehearse every Saturday from 9:30 to 12. Our rehearsal space is at Calvary Pentecostal Church in Port Hope. We thank Pastor John for sharing his inviting space with us. We are grateful to be performing at this church, the historic Port Hope United Church. LJYO can provide financial assistance for our young musicians via two memorial bursaries, the Kathy Long Music Education Bursary and the Bill Boddington LJYO Financial Assistance Fund. Our organization also provides a scholarship for their music students who go on to post-secondary studies in music. For more information about these opportunities, please visit our website. Our next soloist is Ardian Gurjavi, who will be playing his viola. Ardian switched to viola only 2 years ago. Ardian's private music teacher is Lori Mitchell, and like his sister, Era, he has been with this orchestra for 4 years. Ardian will be playing Hungarian Dance No. 1 by Brahms. Brahms wrote magnificent large works for orchestra, piano, voice, and small ensembles. His Hungarian dances were written perhaps more for profit. Their gypsy nature came as a result of working with a Hungarian violinist that he accompanied as pianist somewhere around the 1850s, quite early in Brahms' career. Ardian is busy with his piano lessons, doing homework, and playing with his pet rabbit. Ardian was so eager to play today's piece that he transcribed it himself for the orchestra. Ardian adds that this piece is fast and virtuosic, but with a lighthearted feel. Ardian really likes how this dance sounds with the orchestra.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ardian, for that energetic piece. It is easy to tell that you enjoyed playing it and that the orchestra was an amazing partner for you. If you are an in-person audience member today, a concert program was placed at your seating area. If you are part of our at-home audience, you hopefully have had a chance to download the program from our website. Some of our other young musicians have opportunities to take on leadership roles within the orchestra. Maya Gardzinski is our concertmaster. Kathleen Goodfellow is our orchestra leader who keeps us organized and adds fun activities to help us socialize during the pandemic. Katie Simser and Sophie Goodfellow are our social media influencers. Check out Katie and Sophie's work on Facebook and Instagram. Also, a big thanks to Sophie Goodfellow for creating our In the Spotlight poster for this concert. We also want to thank alumni member Linnea Morris for putting together all of our newsletters. Please know we are aware of the hours that this takes out of your already busy schedules. We have 3 to 4 newsletters that come out during our season, and they are available to see on our website. We'd also like to thank our setup crew from yesterday, and particularly one of our young musicians, Sydney Gallimore, for all her help yesterday. We have learned so much after these past 2 years, and not only kept going, but growing. Presently, we have the biggest orchestra in the history of LJYO, with 31 students and 11 coaches. As well as over the past 2 years, we had witnessed the growth of each individual student's artistry. We have been thrown so many challenges, but we forge ahead. It takes an extraordinary group of volunteers and supportive families to keep our orchestra as vibrant and active as it is today. I can honestly tell you that it is an exciting part of our home life as the concert date inches closer. How well are we prepared? And what are we going to wear is a daily part of our conversations. Back up again. Our next soloist is Luke Gardzinski, who is returning for a second spotlight solo. Luke is excited to perform a powerful concerto by 20th century composer Dmitri Kabalevsky. Kabalevsky was born in 1908 in Moscow, during Stalin's reign. His music has bright and beautiful themes, but there is also an underlying dark and agitated feeling that our orchestra will try to bring out. Luke is working on this piece for his grade 10 violin exam. He recently completed his grade 9 piano exam, and if that is not enough, he also plays trumpet in a band. In his spare time, Luke enjoys music, playing sports, reading, and playing chess. Each week, Luke looks forward to our in-person rehearsals and all the fun that we have on special occasions. Thank you. Thank you, Luke, for your beautiful performance. You captured the lyrical lines and underlying emotion with such passion. The experience of accompanying a soloist when you're part of the orchestra is different from when the orchestra is performing on its own. The piece you just heard is a wonderful demonstration of how far our kids have come in learning that skill. Now I would like to draw your attention again to our concert program. Our organization is very lucky to have many donors who support us financially. Many of the donor names are listed or are noted as anonymous in our program. If you would like to donate, please know that donations of $25 and up will receive a tax receipt. Donations can be made by going to our website and clicking on the donate button, the donate now button. And our website is www.ljyo. At this time, we would also like to thank the many businesses and services who have sponsored our concerts. Thanks to our seasoned media sponsor, Classical 103.1 FM, and two sponsors, Camco Corporation, Victorian Operetta Society, Theatre, Laurier Auto Group, Kawartha Credit Union, Avis Optometric, Alex Alexander Real Estate Broker REMAX, Dr. Michael J. Hubsher, Whitby Mall Dental Office, Lee Caswell and Tina Hubicki Boswell, Real Estate Port Hope. The Municipality of Port Hope Community Grant Program, Clarington Orthodontics, and Long and McQuaid Musical Instruments. All businesses and services contact information is within our program. We are incredibly grateful and moved by the generosity of our donors and sponsors as we persevere to keep LJYO music alive and well. Our next soloist is returning soloist Sophie Goodfellow. Sophie happens to be my youngest daughter, and I am very pleased to introduce her today. Sophie has been studying violin for 10 years and is also working on her grade 6 piano exam. Sophie has been with the LJYO for 4 years and really enjoys making music with her friends. She also enjoys experimenting with other instruments in her high school band. In her spare time, Sophie loves to do tons of crafts, reads, and maintains her friendships. Today, Sophie will be performing Edward Elgar's Salut d'Amour. The piece was written by Elgar as an engagement gift for his fiancée. The pleasant backstory of Salut d'Amour, along with its pretty melody, instantly drew Sophie to this piece. One of the biggest difficulties she had with this piece was accurately conveying the sweetness that Sophie believes Elgar wanted to convey. She worked hard on loosening the vibrato and lightening her fingers on the violin with lots of intentional practicing. Sophie is so thankful for the musical opportunities that this orchestra has given her.
Thank you.
for that romantic piece of music. You did a splendid job of conveying the sweetness of this piece, and your orchestra team were incredibly supportive. Our LJYO Board of Directors plays an important role in managing this amazing organization, and I have great news for you again. We continue to have space on the Board of Directors for anyone who is wishing to volunteer. We are a fun group of people to work with, and we make things happen. If that is something that interests you, you can visit our website and click on the Contact Us tab, and we will be sure to get back to you. At this time, we would like to thank Stefan Hannigans, Baltimore Video Audio Video Livestream Solutions Company, and his live streaming team for their professionalism and flexibility throughout the preparations and presentation of this concert. Our next soloist is Jacob Gardzinski. Jacob is one of seven children, and four of his siblings are also in this orchestra. In his spare time, Jacob enjoys computer games, reading, designing, and building things, altar serving at his church, and is with the Air Cadets playing the trumpet. Jacob enjoys the LJYO Orchestra and how everyone plays together so well. He will be playing Cello Concerto No. 4, Opus 65, Final Movement by Gulcherman. This piece is very fast and energetic and is really enjoyable for Jacob to play. Gulcherman lived in the mid-1800s and was a cellist himself. He wrote several cello concertos that were very popular and are full of technical passages that challenged the performer. Now I invite you to sit back and listen to Jacob demonstrate what the cello can do. are so grateful to Jacob for sharing his music teachers who send along their students to this orchestra. We hope you are happy to see the progress your students have made. Our next soloist is Kristen Woodward. Kristen will be playing Csárdás by Vittorio Monti. A csárdás is a Hungarian dance originating as a courtship dance involving changes in tempo. Perhaps today's most famous instrumental version is this one, written in 1904 by the Italian composer Vittorio Monti. Kristen has been playing the violin for 10 years with teacher Deborah Henderson. She has been playing with LJYO for 3 years. Prior to joining, Kristen played as a young musician as part of our junior strings program at previous concerts. In her spare time, Kristen enjoys reading. Kristen is excited to have the opportunity to be playing a solo for this concert. She loves the fast parts of the piece, and she has worked hard to learn the tough spots for her recent grade 8 violin exam. So here is Kristen, joined by the orchestra, and as the beat gets faster, please feel free to clap along.
Thank you.
That was a really cool piece, and well done. It was so lively, allowing us to join in with clapping. The orchestra kept up with you no matter how fast you went. LJYO has a number of fundraisers throughout the year. This spring, we will have our second walkathon. Last year's walkathon was some much-needed funds. We hope that you will be able to consider sponsoring a music director, a board member, a young musician, a coach, or alumnus you may know. We will be walking on April the 23rd with a rain date of April the 30th. Daniel Hughes is our next soloist. This is Daniel's first season with the orchestra. He has been playing the violin for 10 years. Before joining the orchestra, Daniel sang with the Bach Children's Chorus. In his spare time, Daniel enjoys hockey and woodworking. He is amazed that LJYO has found a way to continue through COVID times and that it has been great for him to have an activity to attend every Saturday. He is also grateful to everyone who makes these concerts happen. Daniel will be performing the haunting theme from the movie Schindler's List, written by John Williams, an achingly beautiful and somber melody. In this arrangement, Daniel's brother Benedict plays a duet on cello. Daniel adds that the music is simple, but it is very emotional, and it has been a challenge to relay that emotion so that listeners feel the power behind the notes.
Thank you.
Well done, Daniel. Your violin sounded so beautiful in your hands. We also want to send a huge thanks this afternoon to our adult coaches for always being there for us and supporting our young musicians. Throughout the last two concert seasons, our coaches have in-person rehearsals, while never knowing exactly when that would be, given the pandemic. Your dedication and commitment makes a huge difference to our young musicians. Would our coaches please stand for a well-deserved round of applause? In addition to performing today, soloists were required to record a short marketing video for Instagram and Facebook and program notes for communications. LJYO has flowers for each of our soloists to receive today. They are the beautiful orchids you will see at the front of our church. We ask that each soloist takes their flowers just before they head out the doors at the end of the concert, and soloists also please take an additional concert program with you. Our last soloist, Riley Smith, will energize us with her beautiful flute playing of Tico Tico, written by Brazilian composer Zequin Habreo and arranged by LJYO's own Mark Vining, one of our coaches. Thank you, Mark, for writing this arrangement for Riley to perform. Tico Tico was originally written in 1917 and was inspired by a little sparrow. Tico Tico is an excellent example of choro, which is music that is often characterized as fast and virtuosic, but with a lighthearted feel. Tico Tico has been a solid hit, covered by many famous musicians and bands. It has been used in movies, video games, dance shows, and was used in the closing ceremonies of the 2016 Olympics. Riley studies flute in the studio of George Lee, and this is her fourth year with LJYO. Her hobbies outside of orchestra include playing rugby, boxing, as well as hunting and fishing.
Thank you. everyone for coming to the concert, whether you're online or in person. I hope that you will come again May 8th. I hope in the meantime you find us on YouTube and give us a thumbs up. Just before everyone signs off, I want to say about this orchestra that what I think we have here is people coming together, bringing their hearts, their minds, their talents in an environment where we can share, we care, we learn, we give, and we grow. We have two students not here in our first violin section, one because of a car accident and one because of illness. So we care about you guys, I know you're watching, and we can't wait to see you next week and know that you're okay. To all of our coaches, I have to say thank you myself. To Kevin Chocolin, our assistant director, thank you so much for everything you do. Board of directors who dot the I's and cross the T's for us, thank you so much. And to Ruth Goodfellow, who's one of those, for your emceeing today as well. Thank you. To our very hardworking crew who amplified the sound today for our soloists, Stefan and Cayman, and to our setup crew, my husband Jeff, of course, always. Drag him along to Hart Summerand, Frank, our manager, and his whole family, actually. So thanks to all these people who make it happen. Now, our sponsors and donors, we can't do any of this without you. So I hope that today you feel proud of what you accomplished with your donations and sponsorships. We really, really appreciate it. Thank you so much for what you help us to achieve. My last thanks goes to these great kids. And I have the pleasure of working with you every Saturday. I want to say congratulations to all of you guys and just keep going. You're just fantastic. I hope that our next leaders will be you guys. Okay, we're going to play Tico Tico one more time, and this time you get up and you groove and you make some noise. So here we go. Don't be scared. I'm going to blow a whistle. Don't be scared. You ready?